regarding research. Research, a way of examining your practice. Research is undertaken within most professions. More than a set of skills, research is a way of thinking, examining critically the various aspects of your day-to-day professional work, understanding and formulating guiding principles that govern a particular procedure, and developing and testing new theories for the enhancement of your practice. It is a habit of questioning what you do, a systematic examination of the observed information to find answers, with a view to appropriate changes for a more effective professional service. Let's take a discipline as example. Suppose you are working in the field of health. You are frontline service provider, supervisor, or health administrator. You may be in a hospital or working as an outreach community health worker. You may be a nurse, doctor, occupational therapist, physiotherapist, social worker, or other paramedic. In any of these positions, some of the following questions may come to your mind. How many patients do I see every day? What are some of the most common conditions prevalent among my patients? What are the causes of these conditions? Why do some people have a particular condition where others do not? What are the health needs of the community? Why do some people use the service while others do not? What do people think about the service? How satisfied are patients with the service? How effective is the service? How can the service be improved? You can add many more questions to the list. At times, it may be possible to ignore these questions because of the level at which you work. At other times, you may make an effort to find answers on your own initiative, or sometimes you may be required to obtain answers for effective administration and planning. Most professions that are in human service industry would lend themselves to the questions raised above, and you as a service provider should be well prepared to answer them. Research is one of the ways to help you to answer such questions objectively. When you say that you are undertaking a research study to find out answers to a question, you are implying that the process is being undertaken within framework of set of philosophies, uses procedures, methods and techniques that have been tested for their validity and reliability, is designed to be unbiased and objective. Your philosophical orientation may stem from one of the several paradigms and approaches in research: positivist, interpretive, phenomenalist, action or participatory, feminist, qualitative, quantitative, and the academic discipline in which you have been trained. The concept of validity can be applied to any aspect of the research process. It ensures that in a research study, correct procedures have been applied to find answers to a question. Reliability refers to the quality of a measurement procedure that provides repeatability and accuracy. Unbiased and objective means that you have taken each step in an unbiased manner and drawn each conclusion to the best of your ability and without introducing your own vested interest. Adherence to the three criteria mentioned above enables the process to be called research. However, the degree to which these criteria are expected to be fulfilled varies from discipline to discipline, and so the meaning of research differs from one academic discipline to another. For example, the expectation of the research process are markedly different between the physical and social sciences. In the physical sciences, A research endeavor is expected to be strictly controlled at each step, whereas in social sciences, rigid control cannot be enforced and sometimes not even demanded. As beginners in research, you should understand that research is not at all technical, complex, statistics and computers. It can be very simple activity to provide answers to very simple questions relating to day-to-day activities. On the other hand, research procedures can also be employed to formulate intricate theories or laws that govern our lives. The difference between research and non-research activity is, as mentioned, is the way we find answers. The process must meet certain requirements to be called research. To identify these requirements, let's examine some of the definitions of research. Definition of research. The word research is composed of two syllables, re and search. The dictionary defines the former as a prefix, meaning again, anew, or over again, and the latter as a verb meaning to examine closely and carefully, to test and to try or to probe. Together, they form a noun describing a careful, systematic, patient study and investigation in some field of knowledge undertaken to establish facts or principles. Grinnell further adds, research is structured inquiry that utilizes acceptable scientific methodology to solve problems and create new knowledge that is generally applicable. According to Random House Dictionary of English Language, research is systematic inquiry into a subject in order to discover or revise facts, theories, etc. According to J.S. Shera, an intellectual process whereby a problem is divided into its constituent elements and analyzed in the light of assumptions. In the Encyclopedia of Social Sciences, research is defined as the manipulation of things, concepts or symbols for the purpose of generalization to extend, correct or verify knowledge, whether that knowledge aids in the construction of theory or in practice of an art. Research, therefore, is not writing books and collecting data haphazardly. A true research is a systematic inquiry to solve a problem or to find new facts or to interpret known facts in new light. Characteristics of research. In order to clarify the meaning of research, we may deduce the following characteristics of research. Research is directed towards the solution of a problem. The ultimate goal is to establish cause and effect relationship between variables and interpret known facts in new light. Research emphasizes the development of generalization principles or theories that will help in prediction of future events. Research usually goes beyond the specific objects, groups, or situations investigated and infer characteristics of a target population from the sample observed. Research is more than information retrieval and simple gathering of information. Many school research departments gather and tabulate statistical information that may be useful in decision making, but these activities are not properly termed as research. Research is based upon observable experience and empirical evidence. Certain interesting questions do not lend themselves to research procedures because they cannot be observed. Research rejects revelation and dogma as methods of establishing knowledge and accept only what can be verified by observation. Research involves gathering new data from primary or first-hand sources or using existing data for a new purpose. Teachers frequently assign a research project that involves writing a paper dealing with the life of a prominent person. The students are expected to read a number of encyclopedias, books or periodical reference, and to synthesize the information in a report. This is not research, for the data is not new, merely reorganizing or restating what is already known and has already been written. Valuable as it may be as a learning experience, it adds nothing to what is known. Research demands accurate observation and description. Researchers use quantitative measuring devices, the most precise form of description. When this is not possible or appropriate, they use qualitative or non-qualitative description of their observation. They select or devise valid data gathering procedures and, when feasible, employ mechanical, electronic, or psychometric devices to refine observation, description, and analysis of data. Although research activity may at times be somewhat random and unsystematic, it is more often characterized by carefully designed procedures, unbiased and directed towards an objective. Although trial and error is often involved, research is rarely a blind shotgun investigation or an experiment just to see what happens. Research requires expertise. The researcher knows what is already known about the problem and how others have investigated it. He or she has searched the related literature carefully and is also thoroughly grounded in the terminology, concepts, and technical skills necessary to understand and analyze the data gathered. Research strives to be objective and logical, applying every possible test to validate the procedures employed, the data collected, and the conclusions reached. The researcher attempts to eliminate personal bias. There is no attempt to persuade or to prove an emotionally held conviction. The emphasis is on testing the hypothesis rather than proving the hypothesis. Although absolute objectivity is as elusive as pure righteousness, the researcher tries to suppress bias and emotion in his or her analysis. Research is characterized by patient and unhurried activity. It is rarely specular, and researchers must expect disappointment and discouragement as pursue answers to difficult questions. Research involves the quest for answers to unsolved problems. Pushing back the frontiers of ignorance is its goal, and originality is frequently the quality of a good research project. However, previous important studies are deliberately repeated using identical or similar procedures with different subjects, different settings, and at different time. This process is replication, effusion of the words, repetitive and duplication. Replication is always desirable to confirm or to raise questions about the conclusions of a previous study. Research is carefully recorded and reported. Each important term is defined. Procedures are described in detail. References are carefully documented. Results are objectively recorded, and conclusions are presented with scholarly caution and restraint. The written report and accompanying data are made available to the scrutiny of associates or other scholars. Any competent scholar can have the information necessary to analyze, to evaluate, and even replicate the study. Research sometimes requires courage. The history of science reveals that Many important discoveries were made in spite of the opposition of political and religious authorities. The Polish scientist Copernicus was condemned by church authorities when he announced his conclusion concerning the nature of the solar system. His theory, in direct conflict with the older Ptolemaic theory, held that sun, not the earth, was the center of the solar system. The rigorous standards of scientific research are apparent from an examination of these characteristics. The research worker should be an scholarly, imaginative person of the highest integrity who is willing to spend long hours painstakingly seeking truth. However, it must be recognized that researchers are human beings. The ideals that have been listed above are probably never completely realized. They are goals just to strive for and are not all achieved by every researcher. Need and significance of research. There is always need of adding new knowledge to the existing store of knowledge, which is only possible through research. Equally important is reorient existing theories to meet the present day requirements. Research is also needed to know the unknown. The significance and need of research may be analyzed as under. Research provides the basis for nearly all government policies in our economic system. For instance, government budget rests in part on an analysis of needs and desires of the people and on the availability of the revenue to meet these needs. The cost of need has to be equated to probable revenue, and this is the field where research is most needed. Decision making may not be a part of the research, but research certainly facilitates the decision of the policy makers. Government has to chalk out programs for dealing with all facets of the country's existence, and most of these will be related directly or indirectly to economic conditions. Another area in government where research is necessary is collecting information on the economic and social structure of the nation. Such information indicates what is happening in the economy and what changes are taking place. Collecting such information by no means is a routine task, but it involves a variety of research problems. Research has its significance in solving various operational and planning problems of business and industry. Operation research and market research, along with motivational research, are considered crucial, and their results assist in more than one way in taking business decisions. Marketing research is the investigation of the structure and development of a market for the purpose of formulating efficient policies for purchasing, production, and sales. Operation research refers to the application of mathematical, logical, and analytical techniques to the solution of business problems of cost minimization or of profit maximization, or what can be termed as optimization problems. Motivational research is concerned with the determination of motivations underlying the consumer behavior. All these are of great help to people in business and industry who are responsible for taking business decisions. Research with regard to demand and market factors